Welcome back. It's time for round five of the Hoppy Open. Here we go. I want to remove this element from the display, as always, because I find this one distracting. Boop, there it goes. All right, and then I need to boost my volume, my volume again. So let's increase the volume back up to 80% now that we're no longer listening to music. What have we here? I want to play the K or the G. All right, that's a bit loud. Let's turn that down a bit. Oops, sorry about that. Promise I think I got this layout figured out. Right, that took me a minute to find a play where we get to benefit from the opponent's X. We open a lane. Unfortunately, we're putting an E in a double-double lane, and our opponent closes the lane. I'm pretty sure this means to eke out a victory, like to barely manage to make something occur. At any rate, or at any rate, my opponent seems to like closing the board, and I seem to like opening the board. So that should make for an interesting dynamic. Hopefully, I know enough four-letter words to get me through this. I mean, next thing that occurs to me is like curl or coal. CULL. ULAR is a suffix. Senu. No, we don't have like cellular. Oh, man. I hope UTE is a word. How am I doing? Oh, I'm behind on score. I really want UTE to be. Well, no, it doesn't actually help my chances of getting a great word. So I need to play a U. I want to play an L. Coal is a reasonable play here. Aside from the fact that it sets up a dangerous lane in which they just played a P. They're trying to do something tricky here. I need to be careful. That's annoying. All right, we drew an S. Our opponent might have an S. Either way, we're opening this freaking board. Iterates. Satires? No. Eastier? Eastier does not sound like a word. IER is a suffix. I don't know. Eateries. We need another E. All right, whatever. So our opponent could have an S. This is not a board that favors the player who's trying to bingo. So I should just play anything in this column for any score. What tiles do I hate here? Duplicated E, the I. Well, the I's fine. There's a lot of I's in the bag. I want to play an I. Something. Oh, sire? Eyes is safer. All right, so if our opponent's trying to do anything sneaky, we have blocked it. We have thankfully also drawn this. A stride. All right. Idiots? No. I can't spell at all. We've got four vowels. There's not a bingo. Oh, we only have one E. Again, we have only one E. What am I trying to do? Okay, ED is a suffix. Yeah, I don't see anywhere like a lasted or something. A staled. Telazed. I don't know. I'm down by five, which is not much. Either my opponent has an S or they don't. That is such a dangerous play. That's a safer play. Right, so we have this special two-letter word that we want to play anywhere when we have a chance. Unless we get to play that instead. Normally, S is a very good tile to hold on to. On this board, it's not that great. Although, it's a good letter to start a word, but again, that doesn't matter here. Like, this entire board is completely locked up. I'm exaggerating. It's hyperbole. But, the basic premise is there. That my opponent, has seen fit to make this difficult to play on, and I'm not changing that right now. I might change it later, if it favors me later to open the board. But they are so extremely devoted to locking up this board that, you know, I'm just going to let them have it. Because, like, they've played a Z, they've played a P, they've played a W. Chances are they have a bingo pro in rack here. Also, chances are because they're taking so long, they have a blank. But I don't know exactly what they have, but if I had to guess, it's probably a blank. They might have an S. I might have just sunk myself trying to lock the board and not locking it correctly. But I was also trying to deduplicate my rack so I don't suffer the entire game. Yeah, maybe I still hold on to the S just in case. So QAT is the play I'm considering, but I know they're going to play something in this vicinity. Because there's nowhere else to play a word. So I just tried to limit the damage. If they do play something horizontally here, I maximize the chance that I'll get to do a parallel play right next to it and score the same amount. Unless they play a seven-letter word and I don't have a seven. Yeah, I didn't think they had one. Alright, so one thing we learned today is that GA, not a word. This is a word, though. It scores well enough. Looking for other places. There's no other places. Just play it. All right. Vape. Vaped. Saved. ED is the suffix. Pave. Pave said. D paves? I don't think any of those are valid, but there's nowhere to place them anyway. If there is something, it would be through this C, but I don't see anything through the C either. Nicely found. The odds of them having an A. 51 tiles are in the bag. That means there are 58 tiles unseen. They probably have a blank by now, because I've not drawn one. So let's just score through this. Vapes. That's worth some points. Even if it gets, like, supposing that's not valid, because maybe vape itself is not an NWL 20, I don't know. But if that does get removed, that's not the end of the world, because my opponent has nowhere to score anyway. Mm-hmm. right. Wait. We don't have ing. There's no g remaining. Even wondering is not worth a lot. No, down is just perfectly fine. Down is better than wonder. So we're down 3 minutes, but score-wise, we're up 23, and the opponent probably is holding on to tiles that they want to play and just choose not to because there's nowhere to play them. So I'm going to put an M here. Yeah, that's not bad. 26 points for that play. IER is a suffix. IED is a suffix technically, but... endeared, nidier, deride, coy again. I could make that into decoy. That would be cheeky and not useful. Rend is the leave here. My opponent could have a D. 14 point. Yeah, we're still doing well here. We're trying to balance the rack. Asunder is the word. Does asunder play anywhere? Not this instant, but after the opponent's next turn, probably. Is there another one other than asunder here? Doubtful. But yeah, I'm hoping. Oh no, it's hopeless to, like, they'd have to play vertically to give me a chance to do a vertical play of asunder. Where else can I play? Dune. No, I'm sorry. Priorities here. Play the D and the U. No, the DE is good. I'm sorry, the ED is playable, but I'd want to get rid of AUD if I want to play a bingo. But bingoing on this board seems unlikely. Outlies. Well, we're going to challenge it because we have to, and it's valid. Now we have to consider, can we play asunder anywhere? Nope. Alright, so we are presently down a lot of points. That's okay. So... ruin? I mean, That plays the U. That's okay. Yeah, I'm not gonna get better than this. This opens an S hook. This also opens the first column. Sedate. We don't have instead. Our opponent blocks column 5. So this is our opportunity. One shot. Let's make it count. End treads. Is that valid? I'm sorry, there's a shim. But that would require. Standee. That's valid. It's not valid, I'm gonna be sad. But only from a standpoint of I'm pretty sure that's valid. I'm like 99% sure I've seen this word before. So if I'm making that up, that's unfortunate. Does my opponent make a comment? Opponent has no comment. Let's play. Sorry for clicking the scroll bar. All right. Fa en ad re. That's valid. Nicely played. Score is even. Damn it. Our opponent. Jeez, chances of them having something good are pretty high. That's upsetting. All right. I mean, there's not like reordered or something. We just need to play through and hope that we get the blank that our opponent likely is holding. Unless we can score a lot of points here somehow. I'm not sure what I'm likely to draw. Regardless which I put there, they could just drop a tile in the corner. That's annoying. That seems to block the corner. I'm not sure if WO is a word. Let's not bother with that right now. The problem is, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 7 of 15 unseen tiles are vowels. So I don't want to have all vowels. Lordier. Well, that's beautiful. Four in the bag. Well, we have to take a chance. Is this the chance we have to take? I don't think so. We are 1 point behind, and I don't see a bingo in there. Oh, crap. Well, okay, so odds of them having a bingo are very low. It's possible, but it's not the most probable thing. Also, we have them deeply concerned because they're two in the bag. They don't know what the two are that remain. They have no idea that I've kept this. I mean, have I lost the game? Yes. Unless I spook them somehow. Now we know our opponent's tiles. In a view or something. Yeah. Blocking is going to be impossible. Scoring is impossible. I have lost. Nicely played. It's literally nothing I can do to prevent losing the game. Not even close. So I should just focus on scoring. Right, nicely played. Very nicely played. That was a rough game. Let's download it. Again, I need a script to help me analyze these in bulk. Yeah, I could use some good luck. I could use some skill too, but luck would never hurt. I guess we could take a look at some of this. Our opponent played very well throughout the entire game. Gate, perhaps not the best play. What should I have done? Also, I have to remember that exchanging is not always so bad. Kugel, Auklet, and Koxa. Auk, Koxa, Kagu. In this mode, I'm not able to see definitions of words. Guk, there's a word I know. Taluk, Q. Galt, Taluk, Aglu, Tegwa, Kia, so like Gunk or Guk is the only one I would have known there. And then from here it just got tremendously difficult. And that's my fault for opening parallel. So I should not do that. Stubborn as I am. Okay, I knew agate. That's a kind of mineral. Aki, I've seen before, and it stands out in the mind because it has this duplicated E at the end. It's brilliant. A key plays over here as well. Yeah. So, a key would have been better than this, and then we just. Well, this is decently balanced. Lunate, Raetel, Lunar. Oh, tell is accepted. I was looking, I think I saw something like this. I saw lure, Lure. I'm like, well, tell, that's got to be Collins, right? But no. Tell's accepted in the North American dictionary, too. Leek, Leke, and not just Leek. Okay. So, interesting. I got to learn some fours if I want to compete in this. It's incredible. that in this lower section of this open event, if I want to compete, I've got to know my force. Siri, I had typed it out, and I'm like, that's not right. And then Ariest Siri, no, I had that in my mind. I typed something else out. The Ariest and Seriate and Leeriest, Earliest. So that's tremendously embarrassing. I played Rise, and that's probably why I lost. Acid, fine. Let, Gat. I was trying to play defensively at this point. Cade. I forgot, there's Cady and Cade. Cade here would score the D twice. That's worth it. Yeah. Instead, this allowed an easy parallel play, and we did pick Paves, right? Yep. Pick the best play, and then here, down up there. I played down over here for fewer points. Yeah, Deke is a word, isn't it? Koi. Mai, I was happy to play Mai. Mai was a decent play. Koi got played again. So yeah, I just missed my opportunities earlier. Wait. Iced. Let's see, could we have played safely here? Ed. Red. Red would have been good. Vaxxed. Vaxxed would have been good. I was concerned that my opponent might play through to C because they've been saving up good tiles for several turns in a row. Seeded, that would have limited the damage, so Iced was a terrible move, and that's why I lost. There's just no saving it from there on out. And that's unfortunate. So let's scroll way back up. Before the break, I had submitted that I had played a botanical word, Fusi. And I don't think I saw any comments on Fusi. And I think I probably, even though it's an excellent botanical word, very practical word you want to play all the time, and not the most common word ever, and I could be given the slightest bit of credit because I'm just learning my twos and threes and I shouldn't know fours yet. But yeah, I think my Fusi generated no excitement whatsoever. That's fine because it's not a seven. I'll just continue playing it game after game whenever I get the chance. But yeah, it refers to a brown algae. Not that I knew that, but well, that was cool. Alright, here we go. Good luck. So here, good God, hacks. Hacks is a word, right? A vax is a word. All right, well, we'll deal with it. All right, let's eliminate this upper right element that distracts me. This thing. This one here, delete, there we go. All right, has my opponent communicated? I said good luck. I played my play. We'll just play. Yeah, exchange on the first turn tends to be useful, but here, playing Vax for double score, that's 26 points. We can't play anything else here. We're kind of at the mercy of what our opponent does. So, I want to play the B or the H, or both. But I don't like closing the board. I feel bad whenever I close the board. There we go. It's not perfect, but boy, that functions. That's 18 points. All right, guess what lucky letter we drew today? We are on a winning streak of drawing all the really easy to play letters, aren't we? I'm joking. There are a lot of difficult to play letters in this game. I'm just curious when the Z is going to show up. So if I had a U, I could play squab. Oh, there's the Z. That answers that question. I'm not sure about this NA. Plus, it's probably not what I want to play here anyway. Exchange can be a powerful play. Yeah, let's exchange. Drop that and that and that. There we go. STING. So if this B were up a bit more, we would have boasting, but we don't. Boasting is not a word. Toasting could be. Yeah, I don't think I have a bingo here. Tangos, except we have an I instead of an E. Plus, none of this plays. Well, a lot of these things could play with this right there. Song can sometimes be. Yeah. Gnostic? We don't have a C. Organize, we lack a Z. Yeah, it's just not a play right now. But give it a minute. Wait for the opponent to open something up. Cut myself a brownie out of the mix I just prepared. Still waiting for the opponent to make a mistake. Hmm. Well, OR is likely to show up somewhere in here. So what's the rest of this going to be? Hmm. Yeah, I don't think I have R-I-N-G, sadly. I don't think Satoring is valid. This was tremendously bold on my opponent's part, and deserves to be met with something equally bold. Want to keep ing. So we're wanting to play the A here. Simply the A by itself is scary enough. Yeah, really. Because then we have A Gnostic. All right. We're not going to agonize too much about that. But yeah, there's potential here. Our opponent might. Okay. Yeah, there's a lot they could have done. Couldn't have prevented any of it. Oh, I forgot. Perhaps this word has been removed. I don't have a list of removed words. That could be interesting. The other day I looked that one up. It is valid. Nice little ditty. It's a song. Is this the right play here? I don't see any other play here. We're down 50. We don't have enough vowels to do anything tricky here. Our priority is to play the U and maybe one of the N's. I have to challenge it. Thank goodness. It's not even a question to me if that was a word or not. I have to challenge it. Evidently, it's not a word. Well, now we know our opponent's rack. The S is pretty much useless on this board. If maybe there was a play dongs and whatever on this triple or double, but it's a few points lost and a lot of security gained. Well, I thought I had an I thought I had an R here. Orange B. We've almost got like a red. No, we've got nothing. I didn't see, like, I don't think Raw is not playable, but refoils, yeah. So I think I've blocked them, unless they have, like, A foilers or something. Probably the best they have is something like Folia. They had foilers, and they played off two of their vowels. Okay, the bag is vowel heavy. No, it's not. 4, 10, 16, 22 out of... Yeah, it's not vowel heavy at all. That's... They're trying to get a bingo, but that's not going to be easy. I don't recall if ope is a word. We're challenging it. Ope is a word. Now we know ope is a word. Rainbows. Rainbows, if you spell rainbows wrong. Yeah, I don't know. There's probably... Well, I'm sorry. There's nowhere to put a word even if one were to show up, but if our opponent opens a lane, we... Okay, we have an S. I was thinking of Saab. How many is the score? 19? That's not bad. With a lave of R-A-N-E. That's not shabby at all. Let's try that. If we had a G here, if we only had a G, there's only one G left in the bag. But again, there's nowhere to place. Especially for something like this where there's no vowels open. I'm sorry, JA is open. JA has been open the longest time. I just didn't have the J until recently. Yeah. Our opponent's trying to draw for this lane here. Yuck. Odds of them having an S or a blank are virtually guaranteed. So, This is where word knowledge becomes important because I think JO is valid. I'm not so sure about JA. What I should do is exchange because I don't like this rack. We almost have hearing. We did draw this, and almost certainly this is like a damage limiting play that also scores. While our opponent continues to try to play something on this lane here, they're going to beat me to that lane, so I need to open another lane. And this lane isn't as scary as it looks. Oh, well. This doesn't score as well as the other lane. And it opens an S hook. There's already an S hook here. They've already played their S. What am I so worried about? This scores best. And leaves decent. Anything I can draw is gonna suck, but I think it's okay. Aesia? One of those funny words that has, like, I can't. There we go, finally. I don't recall it. Aesia means, and I wish I did, because that would empower me to do other words. They had another S? Really? All right. I have anything better? An E in that column's not super smart anyway. Isn't there like CAEID or something? I don't remember. I can't play it if I don't remember. Our opponent almost certainly has like all vowels. So dice here is fine, but the leave is not fine. The leave of two A's, etc., is just not good at all. celiac. This reminds me of like echinacea, but that's not here. Like, it would have to go in the first columns. ECHENACI. Yeah, we were out of letters. Calcite? We don't have. Yeah, we're just one short all the time. Carapace. PACE. Does not fit. Carapace is the bingo. Okay. That's unfortunate. What are the odds that I'll draw a P if I play an E here? We're down a lot of points. It's not worth fishing for. CER or REC recreation might be worth playing. But the odds of drawing exactly the right letters for carapace are like slim to none. Still, this deduplicates my C. Gives me some hope of something happening, but my opponent might have the D and might ruin my day, but we have to take that chance. That's an instrument. I know that instrument. Cadaver. We are missing an E for missing an E for cadaver, and it wouldn't play anywhere anyway. Aardvark. So close. Gosh darn All right, take that screenshot. That might be our thumbnail. Wait. Hang on. Does not quite fit. So close. Still my best winning chance to actually play that, but VP, not a word. That's unfortunate. Interesting. My best play is exchange. Unless I have some like awesome play to burn the tiles I hate the most. But I don't know such words. That's unfortunate. Yeah, I'm not finding any awesome play here. We're going to exchange and beg. All right. Order. Minnow. Oh, that's beautiful. Did I know like odorate or something? No, we can't exchange anymore. We have to play with the tiles we have, or get better tiles. So we are down a lot and gambling on getting some. Yeah, there's not bingo material left in the bag. My opponent has the other blank. It's inconceivable they don't by now. Okay, I stand corrected. My opponent blocks the spot every time here, or tries to. They might not have the right letter to do it, but they probably do. Oh, no, they have to choose. No, they're going to play something at 2G across the second rank. All right. We're still down 71 points, but we got a bingo in. Been leading up to that all game. Yeah, they'll look at that and they'll be like, dude, why did you exchange so many times? Didn't you have better plays earlier? No. My rack did not balance earlier. And while that's probably my fault, I'm gonna pretend it's not. No, I'm going to do research and at some point get a script that can just analyze all my games and point out in my games what I personally need to work on. I mean, the generic advice is memorize all the twos and threes, know them cold, know all the hooks on the twos and all the hooks on the threes. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. And then get memorizing all the sevens and eights that, or at least the high probability or high playability sevens and eights, the ones that are most likely to affect a game's outcome. Those are the ones to know. I mean, that seems obvious enough. But that aside, like I want like the ultimate shortcut for the lazy person. If I were a lazy person looking to instantly master the game without putting in any effort or minimal effort, how would I do it? That's the question I want to answer. I would rather do data science to figure that out than come up with some other way to figure it out. 8. I don't remember if ale's a word. I mean, at this point, we're talking like a few points here or there. I just need to play something that scores decently. That's not valid. But yeah, the four hooks are where I'm getting screwed over a lot. So those would be good to know. But I'd like to see the data science actually back that up. All right, good game. Quipped? No, I looked up quipped. Goo is Collins only. Vax is Collins only. Oh my gosh. Well, there's still room for improvement here. Let's export this game. What am I thinking of? Not quipped. Quipoo? Quipoo? What the hell? Alright, that's the Collins Dictionary, but I'm still curious. Device of knotted cords, used by Incas of Peru to calculate or order information. Also quipo. Quipu, quipo. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, got outplayed. So, like I said, my object today in 8 rounds was to win one game. In the last 2 rounds, I have not won one game, but today, in the first 4 rounds, I did win a game. So I gotta feel decent about that. Algae aren't plants? We just looked this up? Oh, come on. Damn. Oh, that's unfortunate. Algae aren't plants. Let me think about this. Okay, yes, no, you're right. Algae are not considered plants, and therefore are not botanical, even though you could have a botanical garden. That could be a water garden that could help them. That's whatever. Like, anyway. Fluranos. That's cool. Elodius is a botanical word. Yeah. Elodius is in. Could I enter Fusa? Yeah. Damn. Algae enter another kingdom, right? The Kingdom of Greenland. Alright. Jeez. I put my word down, try hitting play, froze, chat, etc. Refresh the page. Clap. Damn. Still look for botanical words. Also, if you refresh the window, that really should fix it. Did you refresh the window? Probably not. I'm trying to remember. Some previous week, my browser had locked up during a game. I refreshed it, and that fixed my error. But I'm not saying that they had the same error that I had. Flashy policeman through ME on the board. Alright, are there... Oh, there is one game still in progress. Let's take a look. Oh, my goodness. Dev? Wow. What is Lilo? A trademark. Lu? This is a monetary unit of Romaine. Oh. Yeah, this is still the North American Dictionary. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Abba, sleeveless garment worn by Arabs. Za, pizza. Ziti's, a tubular pasta. Toyer, one that toys. To play with a child's plaything. A dog, to hesitate. Yeah, okay. Small cavity in a rock or load. Yeah, so I need to get better at challenging words I'm not completely confident in. I was pretty sure that quipped was a word and that I had looked it up, and now I'm confused what I confused quip with. But, yeah, that's unfortunate. So we'll have our next round soon. Ish. Well, sometime in the next 8 minutes, probably. Gotta give players time to work out this endgame. Oh. Good luck. Perhaps exchanging D there was unwise. Wait, what's my opponent's rating? 1400? I am gonna get rocked. Unless something is strangely up with their rating and not mine. Oh, let me get rid of the little good luck in your round 7 game banner. This distracts me, so away with it. Also away with the holding element. There we go. Alright. How do you say meow? Is this how you spell it? Is that Collins only? I don't remember. I'm just gonna exchange again. I'm not such a fan of this rack. Yeah. Koala? Koala is pretty much the only word I have here. Unless there's some less common word. And there probably is, and I don't know it. Yeah, I'm not going to find any great word here. So B, Y, and G, and the A, the duplicated A, I want to play off. Not sure how I play off the YBGA. Very carefully, but no, seriously, like. Where could I do that? Well, hang on. Looking at the board. The board is balanced in terms of consonants and vowels, so I'm not likely to draw heavy on either side. Not finding any, but oh gosh. As I said, I'm not likely to draw heavy consonants or heavy vowels. I drew two consonants. That doesn't help my cause of getting a 7 or an 8. So yeah, I need to start closing parts of the board if it's not too late. Because I was not as lucky as I would like to have been. It's actually extremely hard to get lucky on demand. You just need to make the best of every opportunity and all right, we're gonna challenge it anyway. Now, a dray is a transportation term. If it's not in the book, I'll be disappointed, but there's nothing I can do about that. It's important to have water. I mean, I'm thinking like Tangled, Night Led, like whatever I'm thinking is not valid here. Angled, an A? I don't know. Entangled, really. But yeah, the D, G, and double E. Oxer, never heard of it. It's a word. All right. Would a doxer be one? No, dox, but when you use the verb form, has two X's. Trying to think of an L word, but I don't have one. I think this is valid. See if our opponent comments on it at all. No comments yet. Not anticipating a comment. I think they'll keep it. Not heard of. Yeah, okay, Ba'a and Bice are both valid. Right. It's only 5 points. I have an E and a D. I mean, I wish I had like toluene or something. One of those fun chemicals that just look so cool when they get played. All right, we got duplicated E yet again. Probably should have looked at the bag before. Well, statistically, drawing an E there was improbable, but we got it. Quine is not a word. Okay. What? How is quine not a word? How is quine not a word? Right. Denote. I think zoon. No, it's zoid, not zoon. I don't know my Greek terms. It might be both zoid and zoon. Could be both. Let's pretend that's valid and start looking for our next play. A thought crosses my mind that I cannot even speak on this stream. But a thought crosses my mind. And I apologize that, like, I have to leave it at that. It's such an awful thought. I mean, one thing can be said for certain, and that's that opponents play phonies. Like, we see evidence that phonies are played. So without question, their own plays are legitimate. Is graph word? I think it requires PH. I think the other one's a Collins only spelling. That's unfortunate. Yeah, I don't think gran here is acceptable. Oops. That's worth a shot taking this. Look, we got uwu, which does not play because it's not yet in the dictionary. I'm still waiting the day where uwu makes it into the official dictionary used by this game. And I keep telling people it's going to change the game. Not by much. But in cases that really suck, they will suck less. Does my opponent have an S or a blank? Even if they did, why would they want to burn it on this opportunity? So we are down 174 points with zero hope of recovery. That's my fault. I need to learn more words so I can balance my rack and not play words like denote. Perhaps note would have been better than denote. Almost certainly note would have been better than denote. So I think that's one thing that, like, if I made my own homegrown tool to analyze after games I've played, still would point out practical things like, hey, dummy, don't do that. Keep DE on the rack, even if it scores slightly more here. It's not at all worth it. I think that's one lesson I've got to learn. And we're learning it the hard way. This is one of those valid things, right? I thought so. It's one of those I think has shown up repeatedly. I've never played this one, but I think I've seen it in Grandmaster Will Anderson's videos. Frau and Vley and other fun V words that you just have to know. If it gets challenged and taken off, that's fine, because like this V in the triple does not make me happy with these tiles remaining. Okay, yeah. Apparently that's not valid. Something there was not valid. Refilter. I have to challenge it. And it's good. I didn't have a choice because the game's lost if this is accepted. All right. Eight tiles in bag. Let's just get this game over with. Oh no. Oh no. I cannot exchange with the bag. And if I look at what's in the bag, I am fucked. So, I'm curious what my opponent's next play is going to be. Now, I really want to resign right here, but resigning on my opponent's turn would be poor form. It would deny them the ability to increase their spread. Resigning at all here would be poor form, because, again, spread affects ratings. I don't know why. At this stage, it kind of behooves an opponent to keep the, whatever. To keep their rating low so that they are eligible to stay in low-rated sections in the future where there might be a prize involved someday. But my goodness, like, having two of my plays at least removed from the board this game. Two that I was, well, Quine I was absolutely certain in. Vrow I was not. So having both of those removed from the board, it by itself is tilting enough, but yeah, also I'm just so lost. Yeah, there's no saving this. It's not even worth playing out. Yeah, can I concede this game? I can. All right, well played. Good game. I think my opponent will understand if they look at my rack after the game and see like that just, my rack is just, yeah. There's no continuing play from there. Quine and Wah were challenged off. Fangled and Gino were not challenged. So I got away with two phonies this game and played two other phonies that did not get accepted. So WA was the reason Vro was removed. Not because Vro, but it was WA. Quine. Is quine a word? Scrabble word quine. Oh. Seriously? No, it has like a mathematical purpose. It's a program or thing or so. No, it's a program that, if executed, will repeat itself. That was removed in NWL 20 because apparently it has another meaning. Well, congratulations to me. All right. That's unfortunate. I wish, like, that kind of thing, where there's a word that got expurgated, and it has an alternate definition, but it got expurgated anyway. Like, in that case, it'd be nice if, yeah. It's frowned upon. I couldn't find a play and didn't want to time out. I don't really know how that factors into rating. But yeah, I'll report that these are the facts of the matter. He's correct, he was likely to increase the spread. But, yeah. It's frowned upon. I just thought, like, since I was already down 250, like, I don't know. I'm sorry. Down 282 points. Yeah. I mean, what do you want? I could pass, like, every play there. I thought that, like, surely there's got to be some point at which, like, I don't know, does a spread of 600 change the ratings more than a spread of 300? Like, I'm curious how that's modeled. But okay, let's play this out. So let's say we're examining this. I can't insert a pass here. I cannot insert a pass. If I could insert a pass, I would just insert as many passes as I could, because I'm just not going to find a play. But suppose that I actually knew words. So I could have played this for 15, and my opponent would have played, I don't even know what. They would have played something. Yeah. It's not that I wanted to mess up the spread. If I had passed all my remaining turns, what the spread would be. I think that's a fair way to assess it. I can challenge other things. I don't particularly care about, I don't have a strong inclination on what this should mean for ratings, but I would like to see it modeled out. It's something I've been pondering for the last month or so. And like, it wasn't my intent at all to cause any problem with ratings. But yeah, in my mind, like, if I resign, I think it would be interesting to just model if I had passed every turn, show me what my opponent could have scored. Because I held all the power tiles. Like, yeah. Yeah. So I conducted my own little faux pas there. Sorry about that. Minotaur is a botanical word. Yeah. Yeah. Well, that's fair. Oh, welcome everyone. I'll take off emotes only mode for a bit so we can chat. Welcome. So yeah, I just finished playing a game here. We're in round 7 of 8 for today. Let me just briefly show the final position here. So this is the position. I'm sorry, that's our opponent's rack. Our opponent played this. I conceded. You can't actually see my rack the way this is laid out, but my rack is VWIORRU. There's nowhere my opponent could play a high-scoring play. There's nothing he can do. If anything, like, I'm the one who's most likely to score additional points here. And despite all of that, like, I could play just OH in the corner here. I could play, I don't know, something down here like ivory. I didn't see ivory, but I had 10 minutes to find ivory. If I'd played ivory, I don't know, my opponent probably doesn't score as well as he did. So he won by a margin of 282 when I resigned. Which, in my mind, like, if an opponent's got a lead of 300 or more points, you just cap that at 300 for generating the next rating. If I were designing a rating system, that's how I'd do it. But I resigned the game, and my opponent reported me to the tournament director because resigning is actually bad form. And I think all circumstances considered, my resignation was perfectly fine anyway, but whatever. So you happen to have caught me at like the least fortunate moment here. Let's go watch one of the remaining games. Let's check out Otto the dog. See what he's playing. Yeah. So I've turned off emote only mode for a few minutes until the next round starts. At which point I'll have to turn it back on due to the possibility of things getting messed up. So I apologize for that. Hope that all the shogiing went well. Or whatever game you had happened to be playing. Oh, I'm sorry. I know you all came from Shogi Explained, but for my one viewer, let's shout out Shogi Explained. So yep, for the one viewer that was here already, now they know where to find your channel. Yeah, you give excellent tutorials and such. Oh, 6 consecutive zero scoring plays results in the end of the game. This is true. So, yeah. Apparently, I missed maybe both players are in time pressure. I missed exactly what was going on because I was trying to chat. So anyway, there's just so much to catch up on. But yeah, Shogi explained us really interesting lectures and games, and did this epic Pi Day live stream. What was it, last week? It feels like a month ago. Weeks turn into months these days, but anyway. Yeah, so I'm playing, there's 4 divisions in this tournament, and I am playing in the North American word list classic that is lower rated section. There is a higher rated North American word list 2020 section, but I'm playing in the lower rated section. Out of 7 games, I have won 1 game. So I've met my objective for today, which is win a game. Folks on the site are actually extremely strong, so I need to make the best of my chances when I have them. So here we have a word, alunite, which refers to a mineral that's a naturally occurring inorganic substance having a characteristic set of physical properties, which I'm sure you all knew, alunite, right? The same way that you know, like, wait, isn't this, oh, sick, to urge to attack. Okay, and then we got yak, which is a boisterous laugh. Yeah. So there's some tricky words in this book. Oh, Tinus? Where is that? Oh my goodness. Tahinas. An earthenware Moroccan cooking pot. I've probably seen a picture of one of these at some point. But yeah, that's crazy. Well, resigning does affect the total distance between your score and your opponent's score. And that distance somehow factors into ratings. And theoretically, that distance could also affect who's eligible for prizes at the end of the tournament, if there are prizes for first and second place. Now, I'm playing against players who've got like a score of 1 and 6. We've got like 0 chance of winning the tournament unless all the other players are withdrawn or kicked out or forfeited or whatever. So like, unless something absolutely insane happens to this field of 100 players, there's no chance that I'm winning this event. Furthermore, with ratings like way down in the trenches, there's really no need to worry about whether it's like my rating is negative 100 or negative 200. So I thought, since there were so few tiles remaining, my resignation really didn't affect anything at all other than the duration of the remaining gameplay. But it's still considered bad form because it can affect ratings, it can affect prizes, it's strongly discouraged. I still think in my case it was allowable, because we were so close to the end of the game and I was likely to score better than my opponent, honestly. But they don't see it that way, so that's why you're supposed to play it out. But I was just super flustered being down about 300 points and didn't think it would affect anything anyway. But to each their own. So if that results in me like getting kicked out or uninvited or whatever, fine. I had mentioned at the beginning of round 1 that I don't intend tomorrow to play Or rather, I want to watch coverage of this event tomorrow. And I felt that 8 games today was enough for me to play in one weekend, even though there are an additional 5 rounds on Sunday for those who can stomach it. I just can't. I figured that probably I would not be able to stomach this. But anyway, I made that big preface up front at the beginning of the tournament that there is a very likely chance that after... Well, I didn't put it that way, but I said there is a chance that I would withdraw after round 8. And that's the plan. I didn't expressly say that I was likely to, but I said we'll evaluate after round 8 and see how I'm feeling about it. And definitely not feeling like playing another 5 games tomorrow. Although this is a great tournament, it's just 13 games in one weekend is too much for me. That's nothing against the tournament, nothing against anyone, so. Sorry about committing this little faux pas here. Hopefully people will get over it. So this game's still ongoing. Waggle81 has 22 seconds left to find a play. And then if they don't find a play in the next 20 seconds, they'll go into overtime. If they don't find a play in the next 1 minute, they just lose. Alright, so the two players' recs are AIN and OLE. They're trying to score points without allowing their opponent to score lots of points. Yeah. This raises a question, right? Like, what is that? It's a long sandwich. I'm sure you all knew what... No, okay. I'm just joking. I had no idea. I hope that in a future round I get to play Zep. I'm curious what this long sandwich, like, is flavored with. But yeah. As we go into round 8, emotes only, we'll be going back on. Because, like, it's... Unlike some other super strong players, that hints would actually help me. So, yeah. I wonder where AIN plays on this board. Okay, NA plays there. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. He plays, okay, LO. He's got... Oh, out of time. 10-point penalty. I'm sorry. There might not be a 10-point penalty in that case. Ah, zone of education prioritaire. Education for... okay. Well, sadly, we're going into round 8 here any second now. So, yeah, as soon as this announces the round 8 thing, I'm going to put the channel back in emotes only mode. And you'll just have to enjoy from the shadows. Sorry. So any second now, they'll be announcing round 8. They've been running this on schedule for sure. Because they got people playing from all these various countries. Not just the US. Although I doubt that anybody's playing from Europe. But... Yeah. Oh, my live stream title references another player who had accidentally scheduled 2 games at the same time. Trying to win a second game on woogles.io is where we're at right now. All right. It's only opened round 8 for CSW Classic so far. Okay, that's fine. All right, here we go. Round 8. This will be fun. We are paired against Lake Girl N. Good luck. All right, so the goal here is to get four consonants, three vowels, and get something that can spell a word. And then put it on the board and score a bonus 50 points. All right, let me get rid of this one element that announces good luck, because I find this distracting. So delete element. There we go. Indent. Nice. Alright, so we got cling, right? Wait, ing is a really nice suffix, but I don't have an n. And this scores a lot, and gets rid of a c and the g and the I that's duplicated. Yeah. We need to play that. And it builds toward the upper left corner to help ensure that the board stays open. And why does the board have to stay open? Because I am a... Well, I outrate my opponents somehow. Against most opponents, I am the underdog. Here I might not be. But against most opponents, I definitely need an open board. Because I live for the variance. Almost got Harambe. Alright. Amphibia. We're, like, a lot of letters short of amphibia. Wait, we have four vowels. We can't play that. We want to play HA in some capacity. Is this playable? I think so. Even if it's not, that's not the end of the world here. Oh, and I should clarify that the rule we're playing, the challenge rule, is 5-point challenge. So if I play an invalid word, it gets removed, and that's the end of that. But if they challenge it and it's actually valid, they get to play their turn still, and they just lose 5 points. Well, we have exile. It'd be difficult to play anything other than exile here. Now we have a leave of ALB. Do I have a better place to stick something like exile? EX, no, it does not fit here. Yeah, that's fine. We have jail now. Usually I look for more opportunities, but... Oh, does Yenta take an A in this dictionary? It does, so I lose 5 points, but I still get to make a play. Yeah, under other rule sets, you would be encouraged to... Well, anyway, we'll get to that in a second. Yeah, I don't see a better place to stick that. Under other rule sets, you would lose your turn on an invalid challenge, but here, you're encouraged to challenge words and discouraged to play invalid words, so I think that is a good rule change. Yeah, if we had an E, we could have, like, J-E-U-X would be amazing. We have two U's. Ulu, U-L-U, is a word. We are pulling out all the stops on this one. Trying to find a word. Hang on. I mean, yeah, we could play lube, but why? We want to exchange here. Exchange is the best play. Keeping only IL. Keeping the I might have been a mistake. This is a word, right? It's a plant or some animal or something. We'll find out if they challenge it. They don't challenge it, it'll just stay on the board. Okay. I have way too many vowels. I have way too many vowels. We're gonna exchange again. Hang on. Before we exchange, E-E-E-I, where's one I in the bag? We're gonna keep one I, because the odds of drawing an I are low. Right. Uprised. Surprise. If there were an open S, there's not. Vellum is a... Does vellum accept one L or two L's? I think it works either way, but I'm not sure. So I'm going to challenge it for 5 points. My opponent has five more points now. Yeah, I don't think uprised is valid. Or spuddier. Up is valid. Let's play up. Okay, ERS is a strong suffix. Videoers, over dives, I don't know. Divers. Over dies, overside. Oh, what I'm wanting to do is overdrives, but I don't have enough letters. We'd need two more letters to spell overdrives. Wait, if venom's a word, is venomize a word? It's only 39 points. I know I say only 39, but Ovids is a word. We can't do that. Movie? Movie's not bad. I want to hold on to the S. It might save my butt someday. Right. Is there another D? No, there are two other Ds in the bag. Are there R? Is there a letter R in the bag? There is not. Wait, hang on. Work. So, we want to spell something. There's not going to be something here. I'd have to have an S. It's not worth it at this point. This is playable, though. To regret, to rue. Aroused. Aroused does not play anywhere. OUS is a suffix. OU does not fit. We have to play like something here. Yeah, my opponent took the only S hook on the board. There's nowhere else to stick an S. Radius? Or no, like in the radiant form of the word radius, where you would use all the letters R-A-D-I-O-U-S, I don't think is playable. Grace? No. That's only 30 points. We are down 88 points. Oh. 14 tiles in the bag. We can't play Zep. We could play zero here. Man. So ZA is the word that gets played a lot in this game. And I'm not seeing a good place to score ZA. I think this is acceptable. I hope that's acceptable. It plays off letters I really want to play. Sugars. Re-sugar? No. Alright. 10 tiles in bag. Sausage? No. Sausager? Gauss? Gausser? Stegosaur, something through there. Yeah. Now we just need to place something down here. Fine. I'm not seeing any better scoring plays anywhere. That's entirely accidental. Fat ash. All right. Well, our chances of getting a seven-letter word are not great. Because I need to study more words. Four tiles remain in the bag. Let's see, 7.5 minutes remain. So my priorities here are play HAF some way. And oh, they blocked yeah, that hook. So I need to open another hook while I'm playing FAH. Or I just play had. Yeah, this is probably my best thing I can do here. Safest. Safest. Safest day. Fiesta, I don't know. Regardless, there's. My opponent played on here. Alright. Opponent has seven tiles. They know exactly what I have, and I know exactly what they have. They have QAT. So if I play all my tiles to go out, that would be ideal. Fastest? No. ATES. Bar state. No. I mean, I can't have a word that. So, this is where the S goes, if there's an S hook. You almost have Fat Shadera. Yeah, we're day late and a dollar short on that, but. F something S. Oh, designate my blank? Wait, what happened here? It accidentally put my blank on the board and did not designate it. Feasted. Ah, feast date. I don't see a word. Estufa. Fasten. Fascina. All right. Now there could be a bingo down here ending in E or A. Wait, ASE is a suffix. Oh no. Oh no. If that were an R. If that were an R, then we might have a word. But that must be expurgated by now. I'm curious, but not that curious. Oh, I'm sorry, we could end in ET as well. Maybe even end in AT. But no, there's just not a thing here. Or if there is a thing, it's so esoteric that I don't know it. So, we're gonna make do with what I have and find some play that scores something. Something like this. Ferrates. Don't know. I mean, we're down so many points that this would not make the difference anyway. My opponent wants to play Q anywhere that they can play it. So they want to play QI if there's anywhere to play QI. I don't see anywhere to play Q. Oh, there's QIN. So we have to block QIN if we're not going out. And it does not look like we're going out. But then they have FI. Do they have QI anywhere else? Not that I see. That's known as a cue stick when you try to force your opponent to be unable to play the cue. Yeah, unfortunately, we did not draw the perfect combination of letters to play every letter at once. Or perhaps we had it and I just gave up after trying a lot. My opponent found a place anyway. Well done. Nicely done. I tried. All right. Thanks for the game. Yeah. Oh, Dowers is invalid. What? Is Dower... Surely Dower itself must be valid. Okay. I am... Well, I'm out of my element this weekend. Let's download this game. Also examine it. So, when I played Dower... Dower, sullen. Showing a brooding ill humor or resentment. Dourer, dourest. But I thought, like, varying degrees of dourness could be... Well, no. That's just not how adjectives work. Or somebody becoming dour would be too dour, so you could... Anyway, it's not valid. I tricked my opponent. Yeah. Gotta do more word study. This is the long and short of it. But we did our best this weekend. Or today, rather. Out of 8 rounds, we scored 1 point. Alright. So. Yeah. All right. So I can contact the tournament director to inform them that today was a better day for me to play than tomorrow is. And I would like to see everybody's games tomorrow. I'd like to watch that. But perhaps playing another 5 games is not something I'm in the mindset for. So we could see in my division, I've got 1 win, 7 losses. Everybody else has more wins than I do, including the opponent who got their second win from me. So, yeah, I think that's probably fair. So, let's see. Yeah. Anyhow, thanks to everyone for watching. This is an interesting experiment. I'll be trying to figure out a database that I can load all these games into. I know there are closed source products. I am interested in a free open software solution, so I will produce my own. I will make use of already existing free open software tools, probably MongoDB or Postgres or something. So that's the plan. And eventually I could like write a Python script that could parse the games and do some analysis using whatever software is freely available. We'll see how that goes, but yeah, I'm curious not to take a look at like specific two-letter words or anything, but just try to set a policy for if I want to spend more time coding to come up with an ideal solution that can help all new players improve the game instead of looking at my specific errors. Yeah, I'm curious to make a tool that would help with that sort of endeavor. So we'll see how that goes. Thanks everyone for watching, and we'll see you next time.